One night, Mario had a mysterious dream. He dreamed that he was climbing a long stairway that led up to a closed door. When he reached the top and opened it, he found himself gazing out at a world he'd never seen, stretching out to the horizon. Then he heard a voice say, "This is Subcon, the land of dreams." The evil Toad Wart has used his magic to lay a curse upon the land. Please, defeat Wart and free us from the spell. At that moment, a bolt of lightning split the sky, and Mario woke up to find that he had fallen out of bed, the dream still lingering heavy in his thoughts. A few days later, Mario and his friends had hiked to some nearby mountains for a picnic. Upon reaching their picnic spot, however, they found a small cave. When they entered it, they found not a dark cavern, but a bright and dreamlike world. The land that Mario had seen in his dream. The land of Subcon. Hello and welcome to the deepest lore of Super Mario Bros. 2 USA. Before we go any further, if you want to see more Mario lore or just Nintendo lore in general, remember to like and subscribe and do all the things that you can to keep this channel growing. With that, let's get started. Honestly, I don't think I need to explain the story much beyond that opening. The game has next to no dialogue in it. As always, Mario and his team are able to traverse the new and strange land and defeat its corrupt ruler. In this case, the Toad known as Wart. They defeated him and freed Subcon. Now, none of that is particularly interesting. Wart himself doesn't even show until his boss battle. What I do find interesting, however, is everything else. First of all, the world of Subcon itself is described as a dream world. And this is hammered in throughout the game's story, with Mario initially being called within his dreams, and also the epilogue to the game showing that it too was a dream. So, is that all this was? Was this whole thing just a dream? Well, yes and no. It is definitely a dream, as shown by the ending. But that doesn't mean the events of the game weren't real. To support this theory, we can look at Mario & Luigi Dream Team, another game which partially takes place in the dream world. In this game, Mario is actually physically transported to the world of dreams, showing it to be a very real place. That said, one does not have to be physically teleported to the dream world to get there. In Dream Team, while Mario is physically within the dream world, Luigi is actually asleep in the real world, and his form for most of the game is a mental form known as Dreamy Luigi, which is more likely the same kind of form that Mario and his friends took on in this game. That is, of course, assuming that both Dream Team's Dream World and Mario 2's Subcon are the same Dream World, or at least work by the same rules, but I don't think that's a wild leap in logic, given their similarities. This theory is introduced to me by members of the Marioverse Discord server, which is actually a server full of Mario lore theorists, many of whom know more about the Mushroom World than I could ever dream to. So if you enjoy videos like this, I highly suggest you come and talk to the people there. I'm not as active there as I probably should be, but it's a good crew. I'll be sure to include an invite link to their server in the description below. For more proof to that, the events of this game are referenced by characters that didn't partake in them. Namely, there's this Toad in Paper Mario Color Splash. He mentions that, in the dreamlike state they found themselves in during that game's events, they had a dream about an evil Toad named Wart. Not only does this show that Wart really exists within dreams, but also that he was not killed at the end of the game, just defeated, which actually turns out to be relevant later. Wart actually appears or is referenced more than you'd think. Not only is he referenced in Color Splash, but he's also a direct sequel to Mario 2 on the Satellaview. More importantly, however, he also appears as a side character in The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, yet another game that takes place inside a dream. Personally, I find it likely that this is not only a nod to the Mario series, but that there is some kind of actual connection there. Though that's something I'll go into more detail on when I talk about Link's Awakening. That's most of the meat from this game, but I also want to talk about the two playable characters who have yet to get much screen time in this series. This is the first time that Princess Peach has been playable in a video game. Period. Large portions of her Smash moveset come from this title, but also shows that she's far more than a damsel in distress. She is more than capable of keeping up with the adventurers around her. While she may not be the highest of jumpers, she can use magic to make up for her weaknesses in new and interesting ways. It tells a lot about who she is as a person, even with only the bare minimum of characterization. This is also the first time that any singular Toad has come to the forefront. Before now, they had really only had one appearance, that being in the 85 Super Mario Bros. For the first time, a Toad is introduced as a singular character. One who's quite strong, but can't really jump well. Yes, for those who have not heard this theory before, I am speculating that this Toad is the same who would eventually become the captain later in the series. Not only are there the similar physical capabilities, but turnips reappear as a weapon in Captain Toad Treasure Trackers. The finale to that game even requires that the captain whack down the game's final boss, Wingo, using much larger than normal turnips, similar to the ones introduced in Super Mario Advance. These are clear references to Mario USA, drawing a straight line between the two games and the two Toads. All that considered, this game's location on the timeline is fairly straightforward so far. It features Mario and Luigi already within the Mushroom Kingdom, so it has to go after Super Mario Bros. I don't really have much to compare it to Open Tournament Golf, so that's really all we can say for now. If you want to play this game for yourself, the NES original is available on the Switch Online, while the Advance Remake, the one I'm using footage from in this video, can be found on the Wii U Virtual Console. And that's all there is to say. Be ready for more Mario content coming soon. But if you want to see another series come to the forefront of this channel, let me know in the comments or in my Discord server, linked in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next chapter.